Hello students, myself Amrita Dhar, Assistant Professor of Electrical Engineering Department of Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management, GIS Group. I will teach you Power System 1. In this video, I will discuss about generation cost curve. Now, this topic is included in Module 2 of Economic Operation of Energy Generation System. Of the subject Power System 3, course code is EE-703A. Now, before starting the topic, I will give you a brief introduction of this module. The main aim in the economic operation of energy generation system is to minimize the total cost of generating real power production cost at various station while satisfying the load and the losses in the transmission links. Now, in the load flow problem, two variables are specified at each bus and the solution is then obtained for the remaining variables. The specified variables are real and reactive power at PQ buses, real powers and voltage magnitude at PV buses, and voltage magnitude and angle at the slack bus. Now, the additional variables to be specified for load flow solution are the tap settings of regulating transformers. Now, if the specified variables are allowed to vary in a region constrained by practical consideration, that means upper and lower limits on active and reactive generation, bus voltage limits and range of transformer tap settings, there results an infinite number of load flow solution. Now, each pertaining to one set of values of specified variables. The best choice in some sense of values of specified variables lead to the best load flow solution. Now, economy of operation is naturally predominant in determining the best choice. There are other factors that should be given consideration. Now, while an experienced operator could make a good guess of best value of specified variables in a small system guided by the past experience, the best solution would elude him in a modern complex system without the aid of powerful analytical tools. Now, this module is devoted to the study of analytical methods of arriving at the best operating strategies in power system. Additionally, the optimal operating strategies must meet the minimum standards of reliability, or in other words, the continuity of supply. In this video, I will discuss about generation cost curve, which includes the input-output curve and heat rate curve. And also, I will discuss about the total fuel cost, total heat rate, total input fuel, and incremental cost of generator. To make you understand better, I will do board work.
Generator operating cost. Now, the total generator operating cost includes fuel, labor and maintenance cost. Now, for simplification, we consider only the fuel cost. The fuel cost is meaningful in case of thermal and nuclear power station. But in case of hydropower station, the storage energy storage is apparently free because the fuel of hydro station is water. So water is present in the environment abundantly. So the operating cost as such is not meaningful in case of hydroelectric power plant. Now, the input-output curve of our generating unit specifies, at first we talk about input-output curve of our generating unit. Input, output, curve. Input output curve of generating unit. Okay. Now, the input output curve of a generating unit specifies the input energy rate, that is Fi Pgi, the unit of this is m kilo calorie per hour, or the cost of fuel used per hour, that is Ci Pgi rupees per hour. Okay, now the first one is the input energy rate. This is the input energy rate, and this is the fuel cost. Now, both these are functions of Pgi. Both of input energy and fuel cost are function of Pgi. What is Pgi? Pgi is the generator power output. Now the input output curve, we first draw the input output curve. Now the input output curve can be determined experimentally. Is concave upwards. It's concave upwards. Fuel cost Ci Pgi unit is rupees per hour, and this one is output power. Output power Pgi. Now the input output curve is a concave upwards. Now it is convenient to express the input output curves in term of input energy rate rather than fuel cost, because fuel cost can change monthly or daily in comparison with the fuel energy used per hour or input energy rate at a given output power. So, it's convenient to express it in terms of input energy rate. So, input energy rate equals to Fi Pgi, unit is m kilocalorie per hour. Okay, now this point is megawatt minimum value, and this point is megawatt max. Megawatt minimum is the minimum loading limit below which it is uneconomical to operate the unit, and this point megawatt maximum is the maximum output limit. Now the curve has discontinuities at a steam valve opening, which is not indicated in this picture, in this figure. Next one is the heat rate curve. Heat rate curve. Now at first draw the heat rate curve, then I will explain about it. Output power PGI in megawatt, and this is heat rate HI PGI. This is also a function of output power, and the unit is M kilocalorie per megawatt hour. Okay, heat energy obtained by combustion of fuel in M kilocalorie and needed to generate the electric energy per megawatt hour. So heat rate is heat energy obtained by combustion of fuel in M kilocalorie needed to generate one unit of electrical energy in megawatt hour. So this is the heat rate. Now the approximate shape of the heat rate curve, which can be determined experimentally. Okay, the generating unit efficiency can be defined as the ratio of energy output, electrical energy output generated to the fuel energy input. So the generating unit is most efficient at minimum heat rate, which corresponds to a particular PGI. This corresponds to a particular PGI. Now the heat rate or the efficiency varies with the output power, and the curve indicates that it increases in the heat rate or in dropping efficiency at high and low power limits. Now typically peak efficiency heat rates of modern fuel power plant is around 2.5 M kilocalorie per megawatt hour. Okay, giving a peak efficiency 34%. Now, since all input energy is not converted to electrical energy output, the heat rate indicated in this figure can be further reduced at all points if the conversion from input fuel energy to our electric energy is 100%. Now, for 100% conversion, the heat rate is approximately 0.859 M kilocalorie per megawatt hour. Now 1 M kilocalorie is equals to for 100% conversion, the heat rate is approximately 0.859 M kilocalorie per megawatt hour. The input output curve obtained from heat rate curve as Fi PGI equals to PGI into HI function of PGI. Unit is M kilocalorie per hour. So the input output curve obtained from heat curve is FPGI equals to output power into heat rate curve. Okay. Now HI PGI is the heat rate and unit is M kilocalorie per megawatt hour. Okay, now the graph of FI is the input output curve and let the cost of fuel be K rupees per M kilocalorie. The cost of fuel is K rupees per M kilocalorie. Okay, now so the input fuel cost. So the input fuel cost, that is CI PGI, is equals to K into FI PGI, because K is the value of fuel cost in rupees per kilocalorie. So total fuel cost is multiplied K by total input energy. So we can get the total input fuel cost. Now this can be written as K into PGI into HI PGI. And from heat rate curve, it may approximate it in the heat rate curve. Maybe approximated in the form HI PGI equals to AI dash by PGI plus BI dash plus CI dash PGI. Unit is M kilocalorie per megawatt hour. So from this equation, suppose this is equation 1, this is equation 2 and this is equation 3. So from this and this equation, we get a quadratic expression for input energy rate FI PGI. Now from these two equation, we get a quadratic expression for input energy rate FI PGI with positive coefficient in the form of FI PGI equals to AI dash, because we multiplied this term by PGI, so PGI got cancelled, AI dash plus BI dash into PGI plus CI dash PGI into PGI, that is PGI square. Unit is m kilocalorie per hour. Now, we also get the now this is from equation 1 and equation 3. Now this suppose this is our equation 4, and from equation 4 and equation 2 we get Ci Pgi equals to K into FPGI, that means K into Ai dash plus K into Bi dash by Pgi, sorry, K into Bi dash into Pgi plus K into Ci dash into Pgi square. Okay, so this is also a quadratic expression for fuel cost with positive coefficient. Now, we can write in place of K Ai dash Ai plus in place of K Bi dash Bi, because all are constants, Pgi plus Ci Pgi square. Now where Ai equals to K Ai dash, Bi equals to K Bi dash, and Ci equals to K Ci dash. Slope of fuel cost curve, that is dCi by dPgi. Ci is obviously a function of Pgi. The slope of fuel cost curve is called incremental fuel cost. Is called incremental fuel cost. IC. This is the slope of fuel cost curve. Okay, this expressed in rupees per megawatt hour. Now, a typical plot of incremental fuel cost versus power input. Now, first we draw a graph. This one is incremental cost. That is IC, incremental fuel cost IC, versus output power PGI. Now this is minimum megawatt and this is maximum megawatt. Okay, this is a typical plot of incremental fuel cost versus power output. So at first, now we find the value of incremental fuel cost, that is dCi by dPgi derivation, this is a constant term, so 0 plus bi now, and this become 2ci pgi. So this is equals to bi plus 2ci pgi. Now unit is rupees per megawatt hour. Now this is a linear relationship, and this linearity arises because of quadratic approximation for CI PGI.
Now you have a clear idea about what is input output curve, what is heat rate curve, and what is the expression of fuel cost, input energy and heat rate. You have also a clear idea about incremental cost. Now the fuel cost curve and incremental cost curve may have a number of discontinuities as shown in this figure. The discontinuities occur when the output power has to be extended by using additional boilers, steam condensers or other equipment. Now discontinuities also appear if the cost represents the operation of the entire power system, power station, so that cost has discontinuities on paralleling of generators. Now within the continuity range, the incremental fuel cost may be expressed by a number of short line segments. Alternatively, we can fit a polynomial of suitable degree to represent the IC curve in the inverse form as PGI equals to alpha I plus beta I into incremental cost of ith unit plus gamma I into incremental cost square plus so on. The unit is in megawatt.
That's all from today's class. If you have any problem, please contact with me. My contact details is given on the first slide. Thank you.